Welcome to our video. So we're from the Spa and Wellness blog. This is the team. My name is Christina.
I'm Corinne.
I'm Charlie.
And I'm Hannah.
And today we've decided to come to you guys with a Q&A video. So we've had quite a few people ask us questions through Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and everything. And we thought we would just do a video and just answer all your questions. So we'll just get started. So the first question is, do you have to do exams? Unfortunately, yes you do.
Yeah.
So you have to do one exam in your first year, which is anatomy and physiology. You do also assessments with practical work.
It is mainly like assessment based, but you do have the odd exam in first year.
So you do unfortunately have to do exams.
What's your favourite type of treatment to perform? So I'd say that mine is definitely like facials, especially the Cordy facials.
Yeah.
Because all of their products, I love every single one of their products. Like they're so nice to the skin and they're all facials can be tailored to your specific needs, which is what I love about it.
Yeah, I like facials.
I think all of
facials.
They're just nice to like sit and do as well, like you take your time doing it, which is just
You can connect with the guests a lot more. You're not moving around, you connect like through like their head the whole time.
Yeah.
But it's just more relaxing.
And also I feel like with facials it's one of those treatments that you can see a difference straight away.
Yeah.
So you don't have to wait to like have a few treatments and then see it later on.
Yeah.
Facials like you get it done and on that same day you can see something.
I just find that my skin just feels so soft. I just want to like stay like that
forever.
Okay, so I've got what has been the hardest module at uni? So what I would say is it's definitely got harder throughout the years, so first year was obviously a lot easier.
Yeah.
So I'd say the third year the hardest one was strategic management, purely because it is very fun and very interesting, but it's really technical as well, isn't it?
It
was quite hard to, you know, get my head around.
It was
interesting, I think I would say that was the hardest one.
You didn't do anything similar to that before, so
brand new information, it's like...
I'd say that first year was academic study skills, purely because you had to do harm and referencing, and I hadn't done that ever in my life. We got it there and then, and having to like look at a book to like know how to do it. It's like
college where you don't really do any referencing, and then you're straight into referencing.
Yeah.
It's got to be a certain way. It's like
So for me that was the hardest because I didn't really know what I was doing.
I'll say for me it was probably research skills. Research skill is the type of module that you would do before you do your dissertation on your third year. So to me, I was just like, this is so hard. Like I didn't want to go to my lesson. I didn't want to do anything for it. But unfortunately, we had to.
Yeah,
I'll definitely say I probably struggled with research skills out of all the modules. Because when we actually did our dissertation, I enjoyed doing my dissertation more than research skills. So make sure when you're doing a dissertation or research skills, pick a topic. I've always wanted to come to uni, but I did do my first year of A-levels. Didn't go so well, so I went to college instead, and I did level 2 and level 3 PUT. And during my third year of PUT, I wasn't sure if I wanted to still go to university or just go straight to work, but then one of my lecturers said, oh, they do a spa management degree. at a wannabe university. So I was like, okay, let's look into this and everything. And whilst I was looking into it, I found out that they were doing a management course in London, Birmingham, and here in Dartley, Buxton. So I thought, why don't I apply? Because you can apply up to, I think, 5 or 6 universities.
Yeah,
but I could only apply for free because those are the only options that were made for like, there's no point in applying for anything else. So, yeah, that's my, one of my reasons. And also, I wanted to also open my own spa in the future. And to do that, I needed to have at least the management knowledge of how to run a spa and everything like that. So, that's why I chose to do it.
Whereas for me, like, I went to, from A-levels and I was like, yeah, university is for me. Like, whereas college is more like laid back, I'd say, compared to like,
if I need to go into work, then I knew I didn't want to do that. I wanted to see what else I could do. And it was off my own back that I went to. Because college is just this, go to work, that's it. Only in like this form, they want you to go.
Exactly, like, I was like, that was like the first thing that you always look at. Yeah. So I was like looking at all these different courses and I really know what to do. And then I saw spa management, I was like, oh, what is that? Yeah. Let me check that out. So I came to the opening, I was like, that is amazing. Yeah. Like, I want to do a degree in that.
Yeah.
And yeah, here I am now.
What about you, John?
Yeah, so for me, I always knew I wanted to come to uni. It was always on the cards, but like kind of said, you're not really driven to come to uni if you do beauty therapy. But I knew I wanted to, and I knew I wanted something academic as well. So I was looking at medical courses, things like that, which I was inclined to apply for. I was a bit hesitant.
Yeah.
And then I came across this course actually clearing, actually in August before I came, knew straight away I wanted to do it. I applied in August, so I was literally here in September.
So I've got, are you from a therapist or a non-therapist background? Well, from the last question that we were just talking about, I'm from a therapist background.
So am I.
I'm not.
I am.
Yeah. And then Charlie, you can do that. Yeah. So three of us are and one wasn't.
But currently fully trained now.
Yeah, exactly. Amazing.
But yeah, like, currently it's fully trained now. So.
Yeah. So if you are a non-therapist, you will get trained from the very basics to the very high end of what we're doing. I'm now on the same level as everyone else.
So don't even worry about that.
So, do you have to do presentations as part of your assessment?
Yes.
Like you may think, oh god, like, I hate presenting, but from first year we were like, hate it. The more you do it, the more confident you get. Yeah. So like now, in third year, you go and be like, there you go.
We've definitely developed from first year until now in our confidence in doing presentation and in being in front of probably not a big group, but in front of a group of people and actually talk to them and be like, this is what I'm presenting to you guys today, blah, blah, blah. But yeah, we've come far, guys. We have come far,
So I've got, how hard is uni compared to college? I would say it depends on
the person
and what sort of college you come from. I think if you come from a six-form college or like college you come from.
Yeah.
I would say for me personally, because most of all my assignments at college were all one page, whereas it is a lot harder, but it's interesting, so I'm wanting to do it. Whereas if you're not interested, you'll find it a lot harder.
Of course it's going to be harder because you are going from that level 3 to level 4, isn't it? So you are going from there to university.
Yeah.
But same from first year, it was a lot easier than how it is now, but you do develop yourself.
Okay, name one thing that surprised you about this course.
Ooh.
So I would say how much technical training you get. So as we've mentioned before, obviously a lot of it is quite academic, but we get trained up to a level 5 standard in physiotherapy as well. So we learn all the advanced techniques and we work with some amazing brands as well. So I didn't think that I'd be able to progress that much more as a therapist from level 3, but I have, I've gained so much knowledge, so I'd say definitely that's great.
And you like from gaining all this knowledge and working with all these like brands and stuff, like you get to have these amazing opportunities with people who you would think you would.
Yeah.
So like people, so like the owners of like say Ishka, like we can go and talk to them. So the connections you make are like amazing.
Yeah.
I've
never thought.
I would never thought that.
That was one thing I was going to say as well, is like the amount of connections that you have with people in the industry, it's unbelievable. Because you can just go into different positions and everything, you can have different opportunities.
You can go from there to there.
Literally, through a conversation.
And you can even talk to your lecturer and they'll like refer you to someone. Yeah. And then like, so you don't need to be out there searching. Yeah. It's all here.
Yeah, they'll do it for you, they can help you with finding you a job, finding you work placements during the summer, finding you a job after you finish uni and everything like that. So,
free
and
after.
Yeah,
right.
Oh,
assessments is mainly in first and second year.
Yeah.
So as you're being trained in like the main treatments, you're constantly going through assessments to make sure you know how to like do the treatment.
Yeah.
Well, that's really easy. Literally, you just do the treatment and a lecturer just walk around the room.
Yeah.
And they'll ask some questions.
Yeah, and with the theory, it's more like product knowledge. So they did change it on us on the second year where they did it when we were doing the practical assessment. Yeah. But in first year, we actually did a written theory test, which was like based on product knowledge. So knowing the ingredients of the product, how to use it and everything like that. So what skin type to use it on. Yeah, exactly. But other than that, we don't really have any other
exam-based
things.
Yeah, like the exams are so easy to compare to. Yeah, so like with the exams, you'll be like in a room, like everyone else, like at your table. Whereas like assessments, again, is like you're doing it by yourself, you sat, and then you upload it.
Yeah.
Would you study any other courses to further studies? Have any previous students graduated and studied other courses to further as well? Helps you to get there. So.
Yeah, because with our degree we do modules in HR, finance, marketing, business development, strategic management. So we do
it's all part of the business side.
Yeah, exactly.
Of the degree, so it leads you down different paths. As I said before, to go and do your masters in like business or something. So.
What has been your favourite module at uni? So my one, I'll definitely say probably HR, and that's what I want to go into after I finish. So I really enjoyed doing HR, the module and everything like that. And not gonna lie, I only came to the realisation that I wanted to do HR probably, I think it was the beginning of third year, that's when I decided that I wanted to do HR, just because during second year, we did get the opportunity to be a supervisor at the startup that was definitely spot and everything. And from that, I felt like I enjoyed working more with employees than working with guests and everything like that. And then I just thought, well, if I enjoyed the HR module and I enjoyed looking after employees, why don't I go into an area that just based me on that? So I thought, why don't I just go into HR and everything? So yeah, I'll definitely say HR was one of my favorite ones.
I'd say my favourite like module, it wasn't a module, but the actual learning massage therapy was my favourite thing to do. Obviously because I was like a non-therapist, so learning that, like I was just so excited. I wanted to get in, I wanted to do my first treatment. And then so for me that was mine.
Yeah.
I would say, which might be surprising, but I really enjoyed the spa design. I know you're one of
that
one. For me, I have like a really creative mind, so I love finding different colours to go with like
designing
it. And I just like find in my head, I was building my spa as I was doing it.
Yeah.
See, what colours would go with where. Yeah. And I was designing it.
Yeah. I enjoyed that, just not the theory side.
Yeah.
But anyway.
The theory was a bit hard.
I would say HR and business design.
Are you morning or afternoon, like two types of person? Well, I would say definitely afternoon.
I think that's all afternoon.
Yeah,
you get a vibe.
That's
the thing. Yeah. You obviously do get a mixture of like morning lectures, afternoon lectures, but you're never in uni later than five. Like obviously if you're doing the practical job, you might be in the evening until like 9. Or
but now the lectures are starting until 10, so realistically it's not that
it's not
early.
Bad,
but when you come to
for students,
it is.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah. if you could do one assignment again, which one?
Oh, that's interesting.
That is interesting. Yeah. Because it's
kind of pick one.
Oh, God. As in, like, enjoying or to redo because it wasn't good?
I'd say redo it
together. Redo it together, great. I would say it would be the ones in first year, just any in first year. Because
I didn't try, not gonna lie. I just found it hard, but now that I know I've got the tools to get better,
what I would actually do is actually do my A&P because obviously I failed at
A&P.
And when I passed, I got first, but because it was Captain Morty, I didn't get a first. Yeah. But if I had done it again and I'd known it and it wasn't Captain, I would have got first.
So
that's mine.
Yeah. I think the one that I'll redo, not to get a better grade, but because I think I probably enjoyed it more compared to everything else, probably business development. Even though, me and her, we stayed up really late for it. Like, it was a struggle, but the thing is, I enjoyed it because we came up with our own business. And we kind of looked at the business side of it.
Yeah. If you understood
Where would you recommend accommodation while studying? Right, so Buxton is quite a small town, so you don't have that much choice. But what people generally do when they first come in is move into halls. And that way you get to meet people, things like that. But it is quite a young environment, so if you're a bit older, you can find spare rooms with different people as well. And also, nobody lives in halls past first year. So then second and third year, you can live wherever you want. You can live by yourself, you can rent privately, or actually the uni do a student accommodation service where they can be advised as well. So you've got loads of different options, but what I would say is live in halls in first year.
Friends for life, I think. If I didn't live in Hall, I think I'd just be like all alone.
They're
Weird
friends with people from different halls. If you live on our own but not in Hall, half the people that are here, you wouldn't be friends with, you wouldn't
have known them.
Because people are not as close as
Live with like a mix of different courses, so you've got to make friends, which then you make friends with their friends, and then
So we always recommend if you're coming in first year, live in hall just because of all these rooms and everything.
Yeah.
And also, people always end up forgetting that everyone's in the same boat. So yes, you might be scared as you're like your first week here by yourself and everything, but everyone's also in the same boat as you. So you guys kind of bond over that and everything.
Yeah.
And you just make friends. Just relate. What's been your favourite trip with uni?
I love all of them.
So being a farm student at the University of Derby, we actually get the opportunity to travel around the UK and try out different spas and everything. And all of this is included in your fees and everything like that. So my one, I'd probably say I enjoyed Bath. I really enjoyed that, like the outside pool and the rooftop and everything. Facilities and everything like that.
Which like looked true.
But they've actually had a new refurb, so I actually want to go back and compare how it was to then and how it is now.
I've actually done a blog post on that, so
check it out.
And what I would say is you can go on international trips as well.
Work experience abroad.
That is a definite yes, because it's an international degree. They've got so many different opportunities that you can work abroad. You can go to Canada, America, and all of Europe. But what I'm actually planning on doing as well is after I finish, or we're practically all finished now,
yeah.
Once I've moved back home, maybe like a month or two, I'm planning on going to Canada to work for at least a year or two, just because I like the whole, cause I've been there before, so it's something that I'm really interested in, and the whole experience in Canada and everything about Canada is just amazing.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd get out of the UK just through and
learn something.
Yeah, but I think like you can go anyway, Mom.
Yeah,
basically. Like if you want to go across the world, you can go across the world.
What's the question?